Let's quickly understand the history behind Cauvery water dispute. First of all, let's gain some context. The river Cauvery is a large Indian river, originates at Talakaveri, which is a place in Karnataka, and flows southeastern side towards Tamil Nadu before draining into the Bay of Bengal. I think now you can figure out which are the two states fighting over the river Cauvery. So the sharing of water of the river Cauvery has been the source of conflict between the states of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Okay, so how does it all start? After all, river is a nature's gift. How can someone command a river where to flow and how much to flow? It sounds as if there's more to it, right? So let's go back in time when India was known as the British India. During the middle of the 19th century, the British controlled both Mysore and Madras. At that time, many plans were proposed and drawn up for the utilization of Cauvery waters by both states. By the way, at that time, Karnataka was part of princely state of Mysore and Tamil Nadu was part of the Madras Presidency. Remember that. Now what happened was, Mysore had big plans to improve its educational projects, therefore they needed large amount of Cauvery water. Of course, this idea got opposed by Madras Presidency. And the reasons were simple. If you hold up the water in the middle, how are the people at the receiving end of the river going to get sufficient water? So this matter went to British government. As a result, there was a conference held in 1890 to solve the matter on the principles of modus vivendi. Just remember this term, modus vivendi. It means an arrangement of agreement allowing conflicting parties to coexist peacefully. So the idea was to allow Mysore with their irrigational projects and give practical security to Madras to any loss of interest. They were trying to make both the parties happy. With that, the agreement of 1892 was signed. Things got a little heated up in 1910 when Mysore King Nalvadi Krishna Raja Vodayar and Chief Engineer M. Visvesariya came up with a plan to construct a dam. Now, this move got Madras Presidency really mad and they refused to give its consent for this move because Madras had its own plan to build a storage dam. Again, the matter went to Government of India. They again came to an agreement and signed what is called the Agreement of 1924, which had a lapse date of 50 years, meaning this agreement would come to an end after 50 years. Now, this problem got even bigger post-independence. In 1947, India won independence from the British. In 1956, the reorganization of the states of India took place, and state boundaries were redrawn based on language preference. As a result, parts of Malabar went to Kerala state, Puducherry became Union Territory. All these changes further changed the equation as Kerala and Puducherry started claiming their share of Cauvery River water, because there are few tributaries of River Cauvery flow in these regions. And in 2007, the Cauvery Water Tribunal set up by Supreme Court came to a verdict in which it said the Cauvery water will be allocated annually to all the four states in a certain ratio. The dispute still continues as all four states are protesting to review petition, seeking clarification and renegotiation of the 2007 order. So this is all you have to know about history behind Cauvery River dispute.